forget.
Yeah, and I just collected a bunch of soul sand today. I got quite a few stacks of that. So I have enough to build a 5-layer high nether wart farm following that current design.
Okay. Yeah.
But just not sure where to put it yet.
Another thing we need is a good multicolor wool farm.
Yeah. Yeah, my little collection of sheep has been fine for slowly building up one color, but
right.
If we want to, you know, have a good collection of wool, we'll need something a little more industrial.
Yes. Don't need to go too crazy about it, but just, you know, pens with sheep of each color would be a nice... Oops. Would be a nice thing to have.
Yeah, and that's one of those good things that we could do, like, through the nether, having a portal to it so it can kind of be off on its own area so we don't have to worry about, you know, a high mob count of sheep being a problem.
Right.
I've seen a couple interesting designs that kind of move the sheep along and cycle them for you, which just seems kind of interesting.
Yeah, you can either do that or you can have it move you around through the sheep. Either work, but I don't know how important it is. I mean, if you have just enough sheep in an area, you can just walk around and, you know, clip.
Yeah, if you have like 20 of each color.
Yeah.
By the time you're done clipping a bunch more should already be, you know, growing back their wool.
Yep.
And if you want to go really crazy and you need a huge amount of a specific color, you can just, you know, breed up 100 plus of that one color and have that one super laggy little farm for a few hours.
Yeah. Or we could have an area where that's, you know, we pens of each... some sheep of each color, and then have an area of just sort of, hey, you can re-dye these sheep.
Yeah.
Or kill them off and breed them up.
Yeah, the challenge with re-dyeing is some of the dyes are kind of expensive to make.
Yeah.
So I prefer just to dye two than breed up a whole bunch.
Right. Oh, it rains over here.
Yeah, just right along the coastline.
Oh,
where I'm standing, it's not raining. Where you're standing, it is raining.
Right, because I'm in a beach biome here. Okay.
Yeah, so right now, let's see, where am I? I'm in Savannah here. What if I take a few steps out, now I'm river biome.
Right. Okay. Oh, yeah, I noticed it was along the path to your place, it rained in some spots and not others.
Oh, yeah, then there's beach over here.
Yeah. Yeah, that's I'm in a beach biome.
It's funny because beach, savanna, beach, river, beach, savanna, river, savanna. That is a really weird biome shape right there. Right. Yeah, I've still yet to find anywhere with ice or a swamp.
I've come across swamps, and I have the ice farm out over by the modified taiga island.
Yeah, no, I just want the packed ice.
Yeah, I have yet to find an ice spike biome.
Gotta be one somewhere.
Yep.
And then, I found a few more horses out quite a ways further, and... tamed like 4 or 5 of them, then took the biggest one, the best one, and rode it back.
Okay.
So we should have a few good horses. My goal is just to have a couple good ones that we can breed, and everyone should just be able to breed those to get whatever horse they want.
Right. It's too bad they don't have genetics sort of in the game that if you have two really good horses, you won't necessarily get a good horse out of breeding them.
Well, I thought the way it works right now is that if you have two really good horses and you breed them, it will kind of average out their stats.
Based on, well, I haven't done any testing on that, but on what I've seen, especially like Etho had a huge horse breeding operation in his single player world, and he was trying to do that, and he kind of hit a brick wall with it, and just it didn't seem like it was as predictable as that.
See, I'd prefer if it was completely random. Like breed two horses, random luck, they're good. Because that way, with random at least, you don't have to worry about having a cap when you have like a good breeding pair.
Right.
Where it's like, oh darn, they're capped out because, you know, the one of them's only an 11 heart versus 12 or whatever.
Right.
Lighthouse is looking good.
I think this is the height that I sort of built it out in creative.
Yeah, I was worried it'd be a little small based on the size of the base, but it looks like a good size.
Yeah, so I think I'll put the balcony or platform, whatever it is, on top.
Not gonna go taller than that.
Let me get some more bricks. No, it will go up. It will be taller than this, yes, but I'm not gonna put another sort of pillar.
Yeah, because by then the top part might be too small for the balcony and everything.
Well, part of it is you want to be able to, while standing on the ground next to it, to be able to see at least some of the top.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's put some lights up here just so we don't get zombies and stuff breeding. Temporarily. And then I'm going to, all the top surfaces, instead of having torches, I'm just going to put red carpet on it.
Okay.
And from down below, you can't see the carpet, so it kind of works out. Go here and here. And over here. Well, I don't have enough blocks to completely finish it, but you get an idea of what it's going to look like here.
What blocks are you missing?
It's the... The red nether brick. Did you just kill an Enderman?
Yeah. I realized that I had no pearls on me, and then I saw an Enderman in the distance. I'm like, what the heck? I'll look at him.
Okay.
They can be kind of tough. This sword I have is not that great. It's sharpness 3, but sharpness 3 still takes like 4 or 5 hits to kill him.
Yeah, they are... Yeah, they're formidable, especially on hard difficulty.
Yeah, I did get the achievement today for doing 9 hearts worth of damage when one hit.
Yeah, you know how I did that? Smite five, diamond axe, with a strength 2 beacon, in the, you know, like what I've got set up
in the nether
there.
Yeah, I did mine completely by accident while walking back from collecting soul sand in the nether next to the beacon. A wither skeleton walked up to me, and I managed to somehow one shot him.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, which is funny because that was just with my sharpness 3 sword, I was able to get that.
Did you? Must have been a lucky hit. Yeah, I was going to say, did you get a critical hit on him?
Must have.
Because I wouldn't think sharpness 3 would be enough.
Yeah, is there any technique to getting a critical hit?
It's used to do it reliably. You have to jump, right? So if you're falling down at the time that you hit somebody, that's your critical.
Okay. Yeah, it must have just been random luck. Because yeah, I was surprised that I got it without having a better sword.
Were you at the Nether Fortress?
Yeah, so I was right within range of the beacon.
Oh, okay, so then you got the strength 2 boost on top of that.
Yeah.
So that helps.
I'm trying to get rid of some of these floating trees over here.
That sounds so weird.
I've noticed these zombies are pretty tenacious.
Yeah, they can be, especially the, I can't remember what they call them, but they have, some of them are like master, whoa, what was that? Okay, I'm getting huge.
Did something attack you?
No, I'm like stuck.
Oh.
But no, it's my internet.
Yeah, I've noticed some zombie types that I've never seen before. Like, you know, you have the tiny little zombies?
Yeah.
They had tiny little zombie villagers.
Yes, you can get those now. And you can also, I don't know if they have babies of the husks, but, you know, the husks are new. Okay, that's what happened.
And then I saw a, you know, I guess there's just different versions of the zombie villager now, too, with the different colored tunics and whatnot.
Yeah, you can tell which, and I can't remember whether it's profession or career. I think it's, you can tell what profession they are before, you know, so you don't necessarily have to just go cure all of them.
Yeah. Like, why is the zombie not dying? Oh yeah, it's because I'm attacking it with my shovel.
Yeah, I really love my Smite 5 axe for both zombies and wither skeletons.
Huh.
The only downside,
I'm using an axe as a weapon.
It's slow. So the sort of your recharge time is a lot higher. Is the biggest problem with it. But if you can manage that and you don't have to worry too much about, you know, sort of timing your attack, it's much more powerful than the sword.
Oh.
The only downside is you can't put looting on it.
Ooh, okay.
So for the wither skeletons, I was like, why am I having so much trouble with this? And I actually recorded a video testing. I set up a little command block thing to spawn up, you know, like 100 wither skeletons in a space that I could go in and attack and check to see whether or not I could use the loot, like a looting sword in my offhand slot and get the effect, but it doesn't work.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Huh.
So
I wonder if that has the same problem with bows then. Does the bow then not get that if it's the offhand?
Yeah, so if you're shooting, like, if you're shooting ghast and you want to get the, you know, increase your chance of getting multiple ghast tiers, after you shoot the arrow, you have to switch over to your looting sword to actually get the looting effect. It has to be in your, it has to be your primary equipped thing.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that was, oops, oh no. Oh.
Did you fall?
No, I just dug out the wrong block. Okay. I'm almost done putting the safety railing in. And of course, you know, it would be nice if when they introduce new blocks, like, oh, we've got red nether brick. It would be really nice if they did, you know, red nether brick slabs and stairs and fences and everything, but...
Yeah, or if they even just did that for some of the other ones that have been in the game forever that don't have that stuff.
And even just, like, the new stones that they released, you know, with 1.8, the diorite and andesite in those. It's like, come on, if you're going to spend all this time doing updates, at least, you know, put some effort into, they should do, like, you know, 1.9 was, you know, the combat update. It'd be really nice, yeah, if they took an update, even if it was a relatively small update, and did like a, you know, a building update.
Yeah.
Just to have, you know, just just so it's like, okay, well, we're going to go and we're actually do all the extra modeling that, you know, that they would need to do to add slabs and stairs for everything, and just go add slabs and stairs for everything.
Yeah, and I don't think that's a complicated task. It was just a rescan of an existing model. So honestly, you could probably achieve that in a matter of a couple of hours. The designer could have all those made.
Right. They seem like they're more interested in putting new features into the game.
Yeah, so is there, with stained clays, does clay have stairs and slabs?
No.
So that's another one, because there's so many cool colors that you could build out of.
Yeah.
But, you know, stairs, slabs, and even fences would be great, and a few things. Like, yeah. There's no stone fence that isn't a cobblestone fence.
That's right. Yeah, it would be really nice.
A stone brick fence.
Yeah, stone brick fences would be great.
Because, you know, for me, cobblestone is like, it's pathways, roads, and foundations.
Yeah, otherwise... Other than that. Yeah, because otherwise, if you're using a lot of cobblestone, you look like you just don't have any resources.
Yeah, exactly. But I do like the look of cobblestone sparingly.
Yeah, exactly. Moderation.
Well, you may also notice on the roads that I now have the borders of the roads done with mossy brick, sort of sporadically placed in with regular brick.
Yeah, it's a nice combination.
Yeah, it just kind of breaks it up a little bit. And then eventually I'll go in and probably throw in a few cracked bricks here and there.
Right.
And then some gravel in with the cobblestone to kind of make that a little bit random. So, yeah, I started slowly modifying my castle to add more cracked brick and mossy brick.
Yeah, I noticed a few spots where you had added some. Okay, let's see if I have enough glass to finish. Oh, no, you know what? Once I get the glass in, I kind of need... Okay. Okay, well, I'm gonna kind of run back home, make up some more blocks, and then take care of the rest of this, but...
It's looking good. I like it.
Yeah, I think it's a simple design, but I think it's cool.
While I'm here with some acacia, I want to take a look at making an acacia door, because I think that's the one I was thinking of. And I'll show you really quick if that's the case, because it's kind of an interesting design if it is what I think it is.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it is. Okay.
Where are you? Oh, there you are. Oh, yeah, that's nice. It's a very modern-looking sort of door.
Yeah. I hadn't seen them in forever, and I realized, oh, yeah, that's right. There's that style as well. They're kind of neat because it is kind of like a barred kind of structure, but I don't know what.
They didn't place facing each other. They normally do.
It could have just been my building. Let's see what happens.
Oh, that's weird. I wonder if that's because they're not in a frame. If the exterior blocks. There you go.
Yeah. Now they are though.
Okay.
Well, they look good.
Yeah.
I don't know where I'd use them, but yeah, to me they kind of look like a jail door, kind of the bars.
And you just have to make sure it's in a relatively zombie-proof area.
Yeah, yeah. For now, in the hostel area, I just have the oak doors. But if we want to, at some point, we can put in iron doors. I do have pressure plates on the other side, so once someone's on the inside, it'll close behind them.
Right. No, I think I think these are fine. Otherwise, it's.
And we'll get this area pretty well lit. I mean, I've been trying fairly hard. Like every time I come over here, I have two stacks of torches on me.
Right.
And on my way back home, I just kind of wander around looking for anything low.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I'm gonna go and take care of some stuff. Thanks for testing the Discord with me.
Yeah, no worries. And the lighthouse is looking good. I can't wait to see how you finish it off.
Yep.
Shoot me a message when you have some more work done on it.
Okay.
All right, good show. All right.
Talk to you later. Okay, I think we're pretty much done with the basic structure. I've got to get back down there. And I have a hole here. I need to come up with another piece of red stained glass, and then I need a bunch of carpet. And then I need to do something with this. I need to finish the foundation down here with stone bricks. And I need to come on. You can go in there. Stone bricks, pretty much done with this. I've got stone bricks, and then I got a bunch of wool. So one thing I'm gonna do, I need a bunch of red dye to dye up this wool. The wool came from the string in the mob farm. And I was gonna bring over some red flowers, but VexFx has very kindly planted a bunch here, and that means I have all the red dye I need. Right? So I need for the carpet, unfortunately, dyeing carpet is expensive. Now, you do get two out of each of the flowers here, which is why these flowers are better than beetroot, besides the fact that you can just bone meal it all you need. So if I do this, I get two stacks of red dye, which is nice. But the carpet, to get the wool, it's like, you can do it in your crafting area here, but you know, it's like, oh, red wool. So that was expensive, and then I get carpet out of it like that. So I'm gonna craft up, did I just place some carpet down? I think I did. Okay, so I'm gonna craft up a bunch of, I guess not. I'm gonna craft up a bunch of red carpet and grab piece of red stained glass, and got some blocks and some ladders, and then I've got a few other sort of decorating things in here. I have to figure out the lighting. I don't know if I want to leave all these torches or if I should go get a bunch of ember rods. I don't know. So we'll figure that out. And let me make a little more progress, and then we can show it off a little bit. Whew. So I don't want to leave torches all over the top of this, so that's why I'm putting down carpet. That always makes me nervous. But hopefully I have enough carpet here so I can take up these torches. The red carpet is not really visible from down below. So, and it fits in, and even if it is visible, it kind of looks like red shingles, I guess. Second, rearrange my controllers, and that way I don't have to have these torches. Boop. And then I can take down those exterior ladders as well, because I shouldn't ever need to come back up here. Hey, buddy. Oh, no, it's not for rent. You can't move in. There we go. Okay, now we have to do the roof, which is going to be a little bit of a pain. Oh, hey. There's another one. Hey. Get away. What are you doing? Where'd you come from? It's not for rent. I love the carpet is transparent. It's weird. It's one of those things that doesn't really make sense that it is, but it is. Ooh, oh, where's the beacon go? Well, I had to pillar up in order to get back up to the roof. But we can now fix that, and the beacon will turn back on, and we will be in business. Very nice. Okay. Oops. Switch back to the pick. that the, no, one more. Oh man. Okay. Oops. There we go. All right, and beacon light. Woohoo. All right, so now we need, let's see if I made enough carpet for all this. If not, we have to go make more, but it's relatively easy to do at this point. And up here, we don't have to don't have to have any torches to light things up and prevent zombies and such from spawning. Although it might be kind of fun to actually have like a capture a zombie, name it, and put it up here as a the light keeper or something. That might be kind of fun. I'll have to think about doing that. Have to figure out a right color scheme for some leather armor or something to make them look nice and official. Oh no! Oh no, we still have some carpet. Yay! Okay. We'll have to make some more for the bottom floor, but this should do us up here. There we go. Nice. Nice. So we have a nice view from up here. We can see we can see Risk NC's place. See my space up there? Can't really see Vex's castle much, but that's okay. All right, so let's go back down and take a look at it from the outside. There's a little bit more down on the bottom floor here. I have to put in the foundation, the rest of the floor, and then I have to carpet it. But you don't need to see that. The outside is complete. Let's take a look. Woohoo! Yeah, it's kind of cool. I like that. Should be pretty visible for people coming in from Spawn Island with the beacon to guide them, and then also the structure as a whole, so they know where they're coming. And they come into the little dock area here. We have a little marina, and then the welcome center with the little hostels, so they can come and sleep, store some stuff temporarily while they build up enough resources to get a base of their own. There we go. Let's get a screenshot while the sun's coming up. Very nice. Okay. Oh, there's a squid under there, isn't there? Yes, there is. Hello, Mr. Squid. All right. Well, thank you for watching. This is probably a long episode, but we'll see what we can trim out. But nice, manageable get stuff done sort of episode. So cool. I will finish this off, and then I think next I have to work on the gold farm a bit, but other than that I have to come up with another. Oh man, I should just punch him off. No, that would not be nice. Okay. I like the idea of doing a shipwreck a lot. Cool. Okay. Well, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. All right? Bye.